Greetings, John Ballwood here with the Complexity course. We're going to step through some solutions to the final set of problems in the dynamic series, the advanced level. And this is going to be a lot of fun. We're going to actually build a net logo model from scratch. And you can see how I approach building models. Of course, there's lots of different ways to do it. And the most important thing when you begin programming is just to play around and don't be afraid to make lots of mistakes, because that's the only way to learn is from 1,000 mistakes. So I've been through these models, I've built hundreds and hundreds of models, and I'm sure that I'm going to make mistakes building this one, but that's just part of programming. So advanced level, we're going to make a model that uses agent-based population growth. We're not actually basing it on an equation. We're actually making little entities that reproduce, and we're going to see if we can create a behavior that is what the logistic model of population growth is purported to be describing. And so in a way, we're kind of coming up with that behavior, but deriving it from the actual behavior of agents. So it's kind of interesting philosophically that these kind of models are much more low level, and the actual collective behavior emerges from the properties and interactions of the agents. So let's jump into it. So here's NetLogo, the screen you get when you start off, just a simple interface. When I start a new model, I always add a setup button. Typically a step button in a model like this, and a go button. Now these, of course, refer to procedures that have not yet been written. Also, I'm always careful to line things up and leave the same amount of padding between all my buttons. It's just a pet peeve of mine, but that's how I do it. I also label my models so that I can remember what they are in the future. So there we go. That's the basics that I do whenever I start making a model. Now let's go. Let's see what we want to do. We want to create a bunch of agents, and we want them to reproduce, and we're going to plot the graph to see if it looks like that sigmoidal curve. So we're going to plot too. So we'll just get the basics out of the way, and we will call this graph population. We know that it's going to be a population versus time. It's always a good idea right away to label the axes so you don't forget. Okay, some of the preliminaries are out of the way. Okay, what we're going to do next is we're going to actually make a setup module that creates some agents. So let's jump into the code, and we'll say to setup, and I always write the beginning and the end first, just so, because I know I'm going to have to do that. Now we know that we're going to want to create a certain number initially. Probably we'll have a slider for that, but we can just, let's make a slider right away just so that we get that out of the way too. So go back to the interface, make a slider, and call it initial pop population. And typically I'll copy that and so we're going to create that many initial population, And then we have an opportunity to give these newly created entities some properties. So I'm going to say set their color to green, set their shape to, let's say, a circle, and set their size to, let's leave them. Initially, they come out at size 1. Now, we'll see a problem with this right away. And I just want to show you this because setup now works, and we'll create 50 individuals by default. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to run a setup. You notice that it looks like there's only one agent that was created, but actually there are 27, and they're all created right on top of each other. In order to get them to move, we would have to go, if we told them to each go forward 10, when we ran setup, we would see that they would all, since they have a random heading, they would all move out. But that's still not quite what we want, right? It's it looks too organized and too artificial. So also, we still haven't gotten rid of our initial one. So this reminds me that whenever we do a setup, we almost always start off with a clear all. Shortcut for that is just CA. But clear all will wipe away that. And instead of using this create command, which is the easiest way to create a population of agents, we're going to use something else. And that's the... I'm going to ask the patches, and I'll ask a certain number of patches. Ask n of initial population. So I'm asking that many patches to sprout. And now, of course, once I've decided who I'm talking to. I'm talking to patches, and what I'm asking them to do is this sprout business. I'm saying, hey, you 12 patches, each one of you, I want you to sprout one, and then tell that one to set its color to green, set the shape to circle, and move forward 10. We don't need that forward 10 anymore. So let's just see if this works. Sure enough, it randomly asks patches every time you push it. It randomly asks a certain set of patches, 27 in this case, or 80 of them. So now we have an initial population of patches that we can control just with that one line of code. Okay, so the next step is to think through what are we going to want to do with these. We're going to want to ask these agents, these little green dots, we want them to basically reproduce. They're going to need to be able to die because we want to have non-overlapping generation. So I have a parent generation that gives birth to another generation, and the parent generation dies off. That means we're going to have to keep track of generations. We're also going to need them to spread out, to disperse, so that they don't all end up on top of each other, and it'll just be easier to keep track of them visually if we have them stand on their own patch. Okay, we don't have to have any kind of breeding. That we could do that, but that would make it more complicated. So let's just see how we would do that. I'm going to say that each step in time they will reproduce. So I'm going to say step, or they will do all the things that they need to do. So this is just kind of pseudocode. I'm going to say that they need to reproduce. Parents need to die. and the remaining ones will disperse. So there we have it. This is these are just going to be names for procedures I haven't written yet. But so this procedure step is just going to call these procedures. So let's think how reproduction is going to work.